Brody and I are back. This is the property I hunted opening day. Had all those, that big group of birds out on this field that's kind of back behind us now to the south. I came down a few days ago, sat right here, and they were all off to the north, and then they just worked farther to the north. So me and Brody came back down today, and they're in the same spot. Now we're just waiting to see if they're going to come our way or if they're going to go north like they did before. So usually, if they do come our way, though, they're usually out on the field anyways, which is private, which we can't hunt, and we can only go probably 20 yards farther this way. So we're as close as we can get on this pretty small piece, so nothing you can do. It's hard to kill a turkey if you can't hunt the land that they're on, but we're just kind of a waiting game for a little bit now, see if they do decide to come our way. Otherwise, we might pack up and try a couple, or at least one different property, see if there's anything over there that we haven't hunted turkeys on before, so we'll see what happens. Turkeys are gone. We can only very faintly hear gobbles at this point. And there was one that was maybe a little bit closer, just like a hen or something. But it's gone now too. So they went north just like they did last time. We're gonna go see if we can find my missing striker where I hopefully left it last time. And then we're gonna go to a different property and see if there's anything over there. So who knows when we'll be back to this one. We gotta wait for them to break up or do something because they're staying north. Pretty small, skinny property, but we didn't hear any other gobbles anywhere close on this property, kind of like we usually do or have in the past. So, pack it up, find my striker hopefully, and then go to a different property. Bunch of hens coming out.
So Tom was on the left side, but...
Two of them.
Big old Tom. Oh yeah.
We drove to a different spot here, and I think Chance may have turkey hunted here once a couple years ago. We decided to come through here since the birds on the other property were a long ways away. Got down in here and called, and we think we hear a hen and maybe a gobble. They're kind of a good ways away. It's fairly open, so we're going to try to stay hidden, work our way down this edge, and try to get closer and at least get some eyes on them and figure out where they're at.
The plan is, since we don't know for sure where she's at and we've never hunted here, we don't want to just go directly towards her straight that way. That should give us a better vantage point to hear and to call from. So we're just going to, like Prairie said, sneak up there. We know we heard a hen, and we think we heard a gobble a couple times, but we're not entirely for sure, so we're going to... Might be wishful thinking, but I'm pretty sure. But we're gonna head up around the corner.
For sure, a hen over there.
It's not another hunter, but there's something over there.
Yeah. That was for sure a hen. That makes me think there's a gobble over there.
God.
Heard it twice.
Just
nope, yeah. See the ridge? Just aim for the top of that ridge.
Get up here.
Get right there.
Sit in between. She's coming. Get in there. Brody and I are sneaking around the backside here, and we're just talking about some really good deer hunting spots. And then we decided to call because we got a nice kind of valley. So when we get up to these valleys where it's turkey-ish, we usually like to call. So we called, thought we heard one, Brody hit the call again. We got one to gobble pretty much right in front of us, still in the public. We have a little bit of public to work with. So we're going to sneak up. He's kind of down in the valley by the creek. Sneak up, we'll hit the call probably here pretty soon, and then we'll see what happens.
I'm sure you get to that cedar tree right there. Hit the fence and get to that cedar, because it's going to be open again, and we just learned we've got to have them come to us.
Then we need to hear them
call. But they're down that bottom. It's windy, so they're probably closer than we think. Yeah, probably. Can you shoot through there? Go left.
Well, Brody and I snuck further to the south, I don't know, 60 yards maybe, from maybe a little bit more than that, from where we first heard him gobble. We heard a hen, and then Brody called again, and got him to gobble on that second time he called. But he was down here in this kind of cedar tree, I don't know what else, hackberry bottom, with his hen, at least one hen. But we've moved up and called as we went, and he hasn't called back, so we're just going to hang out here for a little bit under the cedar tree, see if we can't hear them before we make another move. Eventually, we will slowly just push our way to that bottom. If nothing else, we don't hear from them. But there is a tom down here, so that bodes well maybe for tomorrow morning coming back to this area. But hopefully, if we get him today, we don't have to come back in the morning. But he needs to gobble for us one more time at least.